This is quite awkward now.
Hold it.
Lean in, bro. Lean in.
5 seconds. T minus.
Hey everyone, I had the opportunity to attend a riding clinic in Richfield, Utah, led by Chris Birch. If you don't know Chris, he's an amazing off-road rider. He's won Red Bull Romaniacs, Roof of Africa. He competed in Erzberg, Dakar, Hell's Gate, and more. But this was his first time teaching in the US, and I was lucky enough to grab a spot. This was a 2-day advanced course held just outside of Richfield. We had to ride there, and I've broken up these videos into 2 parts. The first part is going to cover more basic stuff: bike setup, seated position, seated cornering, standing position, acceleration, braking, standing cornering, oh shit, and then finally we tie it together with a group ride. So we begin here, pretty lame. I don't have a ton of video of these earlier parts. I didn't film anything at the bike setup, basically how to put your levers, how to put your bars, where to have your rear brake pedal, all kinds of setup like that, how to have your forks and the triple clamp. There's a ton of good stuff, and I highly recommend just go buy his videos. He has videos to cover all of the things that we covered in this class. In fact, we had to watch the videos as a kind of a prerequisite to the class. But when we finally got to this training area, it was pretty dusty, but not bad. We had some clouds coming in, which eventually put the dust down too much, you'll see. But this was kind of the seated cornering, and I was amazed at watching the videos versus just having someone there to tell you what you were doing wrong. I had watched all the seated cornering videos, and then when I was out here doing it, having Chris come by and honk his horn at me and tell me, hey, you're not far forward enough, your elbows aren't in the right spot, like, it was just a much, much different experience than just watching the videos on the couch.
Well, that got interesting. I think about 4 bikes have been dumped so far.
We moved on from the ice rink, which turned into mud, kind of out to this public road, and we started working on our acceleration and braking drills. The acceleration was really a leaning forward movement, and the braking a really big leaning back movement, and getting those to work together was the focus of most of the next drills. And where I really struggled here was the braking. What they wanted us to focus on was braking really hard, but not hard enough to slide, and they wanted us to stop within these cones. The acceleration position was easy for me, but the braking, you can see here, I just keep sliding out, sliding out, sliding out. I'm just stepping on the brake way too hard. I'm not sure why I had such a hard time with this, other than I probably never really practiced this drill before. By the end, you know, we had done this 12 times or more. I was just starting to get the right amount of pressure on the pedal to cause it to not slide out. But, you know, all of these attempts that you're seeing here are different attempts, different attempts, different attempts. After that, we moved on to standing cornering, and we kind of made a huge loop of everybody. There was, I think, 13, 14 riders in the class, and basically just did a loop around these rocks, around these hills, just to kind of get that counterbalance movement. You know, if you've ridden street for a long time, you're more leaning into the turn, and this is kind of totally the opposite. You want to lean over the tire opposite the direction that you're turning, kind of in the direction you expect your tires to slide. And, you know, it doesn't feel unnatural, but it's different if you've ridden a lot of street. So, you know, again, we go through these drills over and over and over. we moved on from that to super tight, full lock, balanced turns. And the idea here is to lock the steering wheel handlebar, lock the handlebar totally one direction and keep balance, basically going as slow as you can without letting the bike tip in, doing that one way, doing it the other way. I don't have a ton of video of these drills because it's like not that pleasant to watch, you know, it's just kind of like doing donuts at super low speed. But it's really building the balance and the motion on these bigger bikes to keep it upright. Then we moved on to the oh shit position, and again, you'll have to watch Chris's videos to get the whole explanation of what that is, but basically you're lowering your body, lowering this triangle as low as you can. So imagine you came up over a hill, you're coming around a corner, you hit some obstacle that you are unable to avoid. So what's the position that you go into, the most safe position that you go into to absorb the impact from this object? So what we found here outside the training area is kind of a ditch that runs perpendicular to the trail. And so the drill in this case was do a loop, get to this point where I'm at, and then hit it going pretty fast, but pretend as if you hadn't seen it or couldn't react. And so right about where that guy just was, now I'm gonna lower and absorb into that impact. And as with all the drills, it's repeat. Do the loop, speed up, come to the dip here, lower the triangle to absorb the impact. That drill and started the group ride. Had to go down the trail a little bit more, but the idea here is to tie everything we learned together: seating, standing, cornering, acceleration, braking, all of that stuff. And we had a pretty good trail. This terrain is pretty varied, really sandy, low desert, like you can see. Seen this in a lot of my other videos, but there's some nice washes and some hill climbs and different things like that to make it great for practicing the skills that we had just learned. So again, we rode in the group and worked our way up the hill to the first really sharp 90 degree obstacle. Now we found this 90 degree obstacle, and that's a little tricky on these bigger bikes. What they wanted us to do, which I did not, was release a little bit of power right as the front wheel approaches the bottom of that 90 degree junction. And the idea is to lift the front wheel, lighten it a little bit so that you can kind of get that little bit of burst of power, lift it up and then hit it with the rear wheel and kind of power through. So there was that one, followed by a little bit of wash, and here's Chris up ahead. And you'll hear that I'm also too late on this one. I think this one we didn't get a ton of drills to practice because you really need a great trail to practice that. But, you know, he pretty much said at the end of that, once everyone was back together, that every single person was late. You want to be almost too early than too late. And the problem is, on an adventure bike, they're so big and so heavy is that if you just go down into that wash and just plow through that 90 degrees, you're going to slam into that like it's a brick wall. And so you have to approach super slow and then gas it. And there was a couple of them here on this group ride where we were able to practice a little bit more, but wasn't quite enough. I always felt like I was just late every single time on this first day. Now, in the second day when we practiced wheelies and some of that stuff, I do think I got the timing down a little bit better on the power dump. So it would have been interesting to have like a third day back on this track to try it out again. Complete. Definitely found the mud. That was fun, but I am tired. Thanks for watching part one, and until next time, enjoy the ride.